my channel Smart Learning Academy. My name is Viren Singh. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the amino acids, basic features of amino acid, basic properties of amino acid. Like amino acids are amphoteric in nature. It shows optical activity. It shows some absorbance in the presence of some radiations, and its configuration system like RS system and DL system. So let's see one by one what is the amino acid and what are the basic features of amino acids. Because amino acids are building blocks of protein, so it is very necessary to study the amino acids because it describes the characteristics of protein. So let's see what is amino acid. If you separate this term amino acid, then it is separated as like that, amino plus acid. The term itself suggests amino means amino group and acid means acid group, that is carboxylic acid group. This is NH3 plus or NH2. This is COOH or COO minus. So both amino group and acidic group present in one compound that is known as amino acid. This amine group or amino group is basically is a proton acceptor and this is a proton donor. If any compound which accept the proton is known as base, and any compound which donate the proton is known as acid. Okay, so if amino group present in any compound, then that compound acts as a base, and if acidic group that is carboxylic acid present in that compound, then that compound acts as a acid. If any compound acts as a acid plus base, that compound known as amphoteric in nature. In the universe, about 300 type of amino acids, 300 type of amino acids are present, and out of which 22 are well known. In which 20 are standard amino acid and 2 are non-standard. Which amino acid is non-standard? The first one is selenocysteine. The second one is pyrrolysine. If we see the structure of amino acid, then it look like there is a carboxylic group which is attached to a carbon, and there is an amino group which is attached to the same carbon, and one hydrogen group and one is side chain. All the amino acids except the proline, have the same backbone of amino acid except side chain. Proline has cyclic structure, that's why the side chain is different in the case of proline. But in all the 19 amino acid, or you can say all the 21 of amino acid, the backbone of amino acid like amino group, carboxylic group and hydrogen group are the same. Only the side chain varies in every amino acid. So this is the basic structure of amino acid. When the amino group linked with the carbon, this carbon is known as alpha carbon because the primary group, chemical group, that is carboxylic group attached with this carbon, then this is known as alpha carbon. So this alpha carbon, when the amino group attach with this alpha carbon, then this amino acid known as alpha amino acid. Then this is known as alpha amino acid. When the amino group is attached with other than alpha amino acid, alpha carbon, sorry, then this is known that amino acid will be known as beta amino acid or gamma amino acids. It is depend upon the basically the where the amino group attached with. Let's see the example of lysine, where the amino group attached with the alpha carbon as well as the epsilon carbon. Let's see the structure of lysine first. So if you draw the structure of lysine, it will look like, let's draw the four methyl group, CH2 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 CH2, and then NH3+. This is the structure of lysine. It is a basic amino acid. So in lysine you can see here is an alpha carbon, but there is also amino group which is attached to this carbon. So just count alpha, beta, gamma, delta and epsilon. Just remember the sequence after alpha, beta, gamma, delta and epsilon. And this amino group is attached with the epsilon carbon. Okay? So this amino acid basically the alpha as well as epsilon amino acid. So most of the amino acids in nature is alpha amino acid, but in some cases, in some rare cases, some amino acids are beta or epsilon or gamma or delta amino acids. So this is the basic introduction about amino acid. That is, this is the simple structure why it is alpha amino acids and beta, gamma, delta and epsilon amino acids. Let's see some basic features of amino acids. So what are the some basic features of amino acids? Yes, the first one is amphoteric in nature. Okay, the second one, optical activity, it shows some optical activity. The third one, it has some configuration system like RNS and D and L amino acid. The fourth one is absorption. It shows some absorption in the presence of radiation. So these are the some basic features of amino acid. Let's see one by one what is this. So first see amphoteric in nature. So what is amphoteric? Just separate this term into two part. That is amphi means both and teric means nature. That is acidic as well as basic. Okay, so this compound, that is amino acid, act as acidic and basic in nature. Likewise, I told you in the basic features, like this group, carboxylic group, is a proton donor. This is the basic structure of amino acid, and this group is basically proton acceptor. And the compound or the group which accept the proton is known as base, and the compound or group which donate the proton is a acid. So the single amino acid can act as a like acid and base. That is known as amphoteric in nature. And the one thing also, there is a positive charge and there is a negative charge. When it donates the proton, it has negative charge. When NH2 group basically accept the proton, then it has a positive charge. So when in any compound, when positive and negative charges are there, then that kind of molecule basically known as Zwitter ion. And that kind of molecule basically known as Zwitter ion. So this is the basic nature of amino acid, that is it is amphoteric in nature. Then let's see the second feature of amino acid, that is optical activity. So let's discuss about the optical activity. What is optical activity? It shows some deviation in the plane polarized light after passing the amino acid solution except the glycine. So first see what is the chirality. What is the chiral carbon? Chiral carbon kya hota hai? What is the chiral carbon? So when the carbon atom binds with the four different group through single bonds, that is here CO minus, H, NS3 plus, and there is a side group. So when carbon atom binds with the four different group through single bond, then this carbon is known as chiral carbon. You can denote the chiral carbon as a C star, okay? But in the case of glycine, this R group is basically H. In the case of glycine, this is H. So here H and H, these are the not different groups, they are same. That's why the glycine is not chiral carbon, a chiral amino acid. Okay, so that's why glycine doesn't show any optical activity in the solution, and rest of the amino acids are chiral amino acid. And when there is a chirality or chiral characteristics in solution, then they show some optical activity. I will explain you how. When there is a light source passes through a polarizer which converts the light into the plane polarized light. This is the plane polarized light. When it passes through the solution of amino acid, and here is the amino acid solution, when it passes through the solution of amino acid, then this plane polarized light shows some deviations. Some deviations known as theta. Okay, so obviously this chiral amino acid, this amino acid solutions is responsible for the deviation of this plane polarized light. Then what is the specific rotation? What is the specific rotation value that the amino acid possess? So the specific rotation known as alpha, denoted by T and lambda, that is at specific temperature and specific wavelength, known as, that is equal to theta, that is observed rotation, and L into C. This is the formula of specific rotation, where theta is observed rotation in degree. How much degrees rotated? Like 15 degree, 30 degree, or 45 degree. L is the path length, generally measured in centimeter. What is the path length here? This L, the length of test tube or the sample container. And the C is the concentration of sample in gram per liter. What is the concentration of amino acid or any solution here? Then this is the C concentration. So you can calculate the specific rotation with this formula. So this is the optical activity property of amino acid, shows by in this manner, and the specific rotation can be calculated with this formula. So let's see the third property, which is known as configuration system. So let's see the third property, which is configuration system in amino acid. So first configuration system is D and L. First one is D and L amino acids. I will tell you one thing, in nature most of the amino acids in L configuration, and sum of the D. Through the translation process in which the protein synthesis occurs, in the translation process only L type of amino acid is incorporated. Only L type is incorporated in translation. So let's see how can you decide which amino acid is D type of amino acid and which amino acid is L type of amino acid. Let's see one example of amino acids. Let's see example of valine. Okay, so what is the structure of valine? The backbone is same. Here is methyl group in the side chain. This is the structure of valine. When the amino group, tell me one thing. In the amino acid chapter, just focus on the amino group. All the properties lies behind the amino group. Likewise, in the general features, why it is known as amino acid, why it is called as alpha amino, beta amino, because the amino group is attached with alpha carbon. If it is attached with the beta carbon, it is beta amino acid. So every property, every features lies behind the amino group. So here amino group, just focus on the amino group, where the amino group is present. Is it left side or right side? It is on left side. When it is present on the left side, then this type of amino acid is known as L-valine. When the amino group is present at the right side, then this type of amino acid known as D type of amino acid, D-valine. So just to remember one thing, if it is in left, L for left, L for L amino acid. So just for remembering the things, you can learn from this, the left to L, and for right it is D. Then second configuration system is R and S configuration system. So let's see what is R and S configuration system. Let's take one example here also. Valine COO minus H NS3 plus and CH3. So it is R configuration or S configuration? How would you know? Just look at this example. I will tell you how to consider it is R and S configuration system. In many books they have given that key for counting the numbers, like 1, here is 1, 2, 3 and 4, and the swapping principle applies here to swap at the bottom position. I am explaining a golden rule here. You don't need to use the swapping principle, or don't need to confuse where to use R system or where to use S system. Just look at this example also. Here is a COO minus, here is NS3 plus. Simple example of valine. Just count the atoms in their atomic number. That here is the first, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. And from 1, 2, 3, 4, just round out the cycle. Just make the cycle. It is clockwise. Then if it is clockwise, then the golden rule says it is S configuration. When it is clockwise, it is S configuration. If the structure is like that, and if you see, if the valine structure is like D type of valine structure, D amino acid, then just mark the atoms 1, 2, this is 3 and this is 4, and just make the circle like 1, 2 and 3 in the increasing order, and this is anti-clockwise. When the circle is anti-clockwise, then it is R. You no need to swap the hydrogen atom here to the bottom position. Just mark the number, and just make the circle, and if it is clockwise then it is S configuration system, and if it is anti-clockwise then it is a R configuration system. Just a simple golden rule here you can apply with any amino acid or with any carbon compound, with any chiral compound. Okay, so this is the third property of amino acid, that is configuration system. Let's see the fourth property of amino acid, known as absorption. So let's see the absorption property of amino acid. So for the absorption, there is a simple phenomena, that is localization of electron. Okay, localization of electron, that is movement of electron in the simple structure of amino acid, like here in all the amino acid there is no continuous revolution of electron, that is there is no benzene ring. So in benzene ring, as you see here is the continuous revolution. In benzene ring there is a continuous revolution of electron, that's why here you can store the energy or you can emit the energy. That's why there is three basic amino acids, that is aromatic amino acids, which is responsible for the absorption or absorption of radiation in the amino acid solution. What are that those aromatic amino acid, like phenylalanine, tryptophan and tyrosine. So these three aromatic rings, because in the three aromatic amino acid there is a benzene ring, that's why they are the responsible for the absorption process. Phenylalanine absorb the radiation, maximum radiation at 257 nanometer, and the tyrosine, which absorb the maximum radiation at 274 nanometer, and the tryptophan, which absorbs the radiation at maximum at 280 nanometer. So just remember the things: phenylalanine absorbs the maximum radiation at 257 nanometer. Here for the tryptophan it is 280 nanometer, and for the tyrosine the maximum absorption at the 274 nanometer. If we see the graph between extinction coefficient and the radiation, here is a extinction coefficient and radiation. So what is extinction coefficient? If you don't know what is extinction coefficient, then recall the Beer-Lambert law. What Beer-Lambert law says, that absorption of the radiations, okay, is directly proportional to the concentration of the solution. This is said by the Beer, and absorption is directly proportional to the path length, is said by the Lambert. After combining the both principle, one common law is there, that is known as Beer-Lambert law, that is absorption is directly proportional to the C into L. If you remove the proportionality constant, absorption is equal to extinction coefficient epsilon C concentration and the length. Here this E is the extinction coefficient. So E is the extinction coefficient and lambda is the radiation. When you draw the graph, then this is the tryptophan 280 nanometer and this is the tyrosine. So tryptophan has the higher absorption, higher extinction coefficient as compared to the tyrosine. So this is the one feature of amino acid. So as I have discussed the four important features of amino acid, first one is amphoteric in nature, second one is it shows some optical activity, it shows chirality, and the third one is it configuration system, DNL system and RNL system, and the fourth feature is absorption of radiation. Here three basic aromatic amino acid shows the absorbance at some nanometer, like 257 nanometer for the phenylalanine, 280 nanometer for the tryptophan and 274 nanometer for the tyrosine. So this is the basic feature of amino acid. In the next video we will discuss about the classification of amino acid and structures of amino acid. Till then, thank you for watching this video. Please do like and subscribe my channel and share this video to those students who doesn't afford the study for the coaching and other purposes. आपको वीडियो कैसा लगा प्लीज कमेंट करके बताइए मुझे वीडियो कैसा लगा. आपकी कोई क्वेरीज है या कोई क्वेश्चन है तो आप कमेंट बॉक्स में डाल सकते हैं. हमारा फेसबुक पेज भी है स्मार्ट लर्निंग एकेडमी के नाम से और फेसबुक ग्रुप भी है. आप वहाँ पे ऐड हो सकते हैं. वहाँ पे बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस अवेलेबल हैं, बुक्स अवेलेबल हैं, ड्राइव फॉर्म में आप वहाँ से डाउनलोड भी कर सकते हैं. कई सारे स्टूडेंट्स हैं जो ये पूछते हैं कि क्वेश्चंस और बुक्स जो मैंने वीडियोस में अपने डाले वो कहाँ से अवेलेबल हो, कहाँ अवेलेबल हो, तो आप उसके लिए हमारे फेसबुक ग्रुप से जुड़े, वहाँ पे लिंक दिया हुआ है, आप वहाँ से डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं. और अगर आपकी कोई क्वेरीज है तो आप यहाँ कमेंट बॉक्स में पूछ सकते हैं या डायरेक्ट हमारे फेसबुक ग्रुप या पेज पे डाल सकते हैं. थैंक यू वेरी मच.